Okay, so we're back again with our next lesson this morning. So, it talks about now with our infinite geometric series. So, we have a given problem. We need to determine the sum of this infinite geometric series, 20 plus 10 plus 5 to infinity. Okay, now, in determining the sum of an infinite geometric series, it's different with the process in having a finite geometric series, because in finite geometric series we have a specific set of numbers that we need to add, while here in infinite geometric series we have infinite set of numbers that we need to add. So that is basically a very challenging task for us to determine the sum of a given infinite geometric series. So please take note that in solving for infinite geometric series, we have a certain formula to be used. So that is the sum symbol, infinite. Okay, so the sum symbol of infinite, this is the sum, the symbol for infinite, equals. Okay, so if you have my learning body, you can also refer it to your my learning body. So that the sum of an infinite geometric series is equal to a sub 1 over 1 minus r. Okay, so again, that is the sum of an infinite geometric series is equal to a sub 1 over 1 minus r, wherein, okay, where the absolute value of r should be, okay, I'm sorry, should be less than 1. Okay, there is a specific rule that for to give us for the sum of an infinite geometric series is equal to a sub 1 over 1 minus r, wherein your r or the absolute value of r should be less than 1. Meaning to say, your r will always be less than 1. So we can only use this kind of formula if your r is less than 1. Okay? Because if your r is greater than 1, that is absolutely useless for us to find for the infinite geometric series, because there is an infinite numbers. So for example, if you have an r that is greater than 1, like for example, if your r is 2, you 2 times 2, 4, 4 times 2, and so on and so forth until the biggest number that you know. So therefore, we cannot solve for that certain kind of problem. So again, we can only solve this kind of problem, or you can use this kind of formula, if your r is less than 1. Now, please take note that your r should be in absolute value, which means whatever value of your r, it should be a positive number. So for example, if ever you have an r that is a negative number, you just change that negative number to a positive number, because your r should be in absolute value. So when we say absolute value, there is no negative number. Okay, if that's clear, let's try to solve now the problem. Now, to solve this problem, we need again the different criteria to solve it. You need to solve for your a sub 1. Your a sub 1, again, based on our previous lessons, your a sub 1 is the first term. And our first term in the problem from 20, 10, and 5, it is 20. That's correct. Okay. The next thing that you do is also indicate the value of your r. So again, the r is the common ratio, wherein by solving your r or common ratio, just divide these numbers from the right going to the left. So if ever you have 5, okay, 5 divided by 10, okay, this is 5 divided by 10, that is equal to 1/2, or you also get 0.5. You can use different methods. You can have fraction or a decimal. It depends on you. Okay, another set is 10 divided by 2. 20. So 10 divided by 20, that is 1/2 again, or basically that is 0.5. So it depends on you what specific fraction or decimal that you will use in solving this problem. So for myself, I will use the fraction, which is your common ratio is 1/2. Okay, now these are the only two things or requirements to solve for the infinite geometric series. So try to solve it. So based on the formula, the sum of the infinite geometric series is equal to a sub 1 over 1 minus r. Okay? So by just simply substituting the given problem to the formula, your a sub 1 is equal to 20 over 1 minus your r is 1 half. So please take note, your r is less than 1, so therefore it is an infinite geometric series. So 20, copy. What is 1 minus 1 half? So 1 minus 1 half is 1 half. Okay. Therefore, what is 20 divided by 1 half? You can use your calculator. You can also do it manually. So 20 divided by 1 half, that is basically 40. So the sum of the infinite geometric series of 10, or 20, 10, and 5 is equal to 40. Okay, that's all. Thank you.